Welcome to Animaker Tips. I'm your host, Ian Maigua, and today we're going to talk about the Animaker Multi-Move tool. The advantage of this tool is you can be able to animate any walk cycle, any flight cycle, any run cycle featured in Animaker. So let's get started. All right, the first thing you need to do is go to www.animaker.com. Now, since you're on animaker.com, you have to sign up. So click the sign up button. Once you've done that, you will see a place to put your name, your email, your password. Fill it in and then press the sign up button. If you already have an Animaker account, you'll need to click the login button. Once you've done that, you just put in your email and your password and you'll be able to log in. Once you've logged in, you'll see your dashboard. In order to create a new Animaker project, you'll need to click the Launch Now button. Once you've clicked the button, you'll see several templates. The one we're going to choose is the blank template. You can see it on the left side of your screen. Once you click on it, the project will load. Once your Animaker project has loaded, you'll need to just simply click the X button right here in order to close off the pop-up tutorial. Okay, the first step, click on the character icon menu. You'll find it on the right side of your screen. Once you click it, you'll see a numerous set of characters that are available in Animaker. All you gotta do is scroll down to see the various characters that are available. You might notice that many of them have the word upgrade. That basically means that you need to upgrade your Animaker account into a premium account. However, for this tutorial, I'm just going to focus on the free available characters. I chose to pick the Smiling Man. He's located on the second square. Click it. When you've clicked on the male character, you should instantly see a window appear directly on top of him. This is known as the Animaker item menu. I want you to click on the gear icon. It's the fifth one right here, because this will enable you to access and use the various animated movements that have been created for this character. Choose the walking cycle animation, which is located on the third square, which is right here. After selecting the walking cycle animation, you will see the Animaker item menu appear directly on top of the character. Click the multi-move button that is located as the first icon in the Animaker item menu. Once you've clicked the icon, you'll need to activate the multi-move feature by pressing the start button. Place your cursor on the character and then drag the character from the right side of the screen to the left side of the screen. Once you've done that, click the Add button. You can find it directly on top of the character. By doing this, you'll tell the Animaker program that you want to move the character from the right side to the left side. Now, in order to play the animation, you'll need to click on the Play button, which is located on the left side of the Animaker timeline. You may have noticed that when you press the play button, the character appeared to walk quickly across the screen. This fast walk cycle occurs because Animaker usually places the distance between two pins to be about 0.5 seconds. In order to fix this, you'll need to scroll down to the bottom of the screen and select the face icon that is inside the timeline. When you click on the face icon, you will notice a small picture of the character that we animated, which is located on the right side of the face icon. You will need to select this image in order to see the two pins that I was referring to in this tutorial. Since we want to slow down the walk, you will need to grab the second pin and drag it to about 6 seconds. When you click on the play button and preview the animation, you'll notice that the walk cycle has become much slower. So remember this principle. In order to speed up your animation, you'll need to make sure that the pins are very close to each other. However, if you want to slow down your animation, you You'll need to space the pins farther apart. The next awesome feature that Animaker has included in this program is that you can change the expression of the character as it walks. Go to your second position and click the property button. This button is represented as the gear icon in the Animaker item menu. Once you've clicked the button, the property menu will appear on the left side of your screen. Click on the face icon that is placed as the second button in the property menu. When you have selected that button, you'll be given three different walk cycles: a normal walk cycle, a happy walk cycle, and a sad walk cycle. I chose the happy walk cycle and clicked the play button. As you can see, the character is walking across the screen with an optimistic attitude. Now that you've learned how to use the Animaker multi-move tool, you can be able to apply it to the numerous animations that are available in this program, such as run cycles, sneaking walk cycles, flight animation cycles, and much more. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, share it with your friends, and if you want to learn more about how to use this program, check out our site, animakertips.com. That is animakertips.com. You can find the link in the description.